I could have put on that white dress and just run behind him. And really added the performance, you know, but you've just done that with a throat infection. Like, seriously? Seriously, your power is unreal. Wow, Zoe.
Am I on?
Yeah, I am.
Girl, honestly, I can't swear, but I can't sing that song. Like, without a sore throat, never mind, like, with a throat infection, that was it. And I know what you're feeling right now, you're like, really, like, you feel crappy right now, don't you? And you're like, oh, I bet that was awful, but it would. You go home and you listen, you play that back, you listen to it, and you think, you'll be shocked with yourself. Like, I know what it's like. I couldn't think of anything worse than having to do this, especially this season, with a throat infection, no. That's like my worst fear. But your control was unreal, considering your control was unreal. And somehow you still made it look effortless. Like, I could see you to the end. You started getting tired and stuff, but you pulled through it. You honestly, you did amazing. And the little riffs and your range is just amazing. Honestly, considering you got so throat, that was leaps and bounds from last week as well. So well done. Amazing.
Thank you.
Yeah, I think you've done really well for a throat infection. Your technical side was, well, really strong. The only thing I think is, if you had lowered the key a bit, I think it would have been better for you because of your throat. But your higher register is lovely and the power behind your voice is really strong as well. And it was such a massive risk of a song to take on anyway. So, yeah, well done for doing that. And you sound brilliantly. Well done.
Thanks, Sam.
Yeah, Rihanna, I've got to commend you again for getting up there with a sore throat. So, first of all, well done for that, because it's not easy. The first thing initially I would have done as a singer is I would have made sure the song still stood out, but was comfortable in my range. Because in a way, I'm kind of gutted, because I would have loved to see now with your throat bang on. So I'm a little bit gutted because I didn't get to see that. But nevertheless, there was many sections now. There was a few parts, obviously, where you couldn't fully go for it. I'm not too sure if the key could have gone down actually, but just in general, never mind the sore throat, I could, don't know if it could have gone down a little bit to fit your range of where you are, and the belts would have come out even thicker too, but that could, I don't know if it's because of the sore throat or if it's because of what, I don't, obviously it's hard to judge it on, you know, trying to see it as a full performance, but there were so many sections in there then, it's even some of the smaller parts, the first three quarters of it was bang on, absolutely stunning, with or without a sore throat. When you get to that middle part then, where it starts to build and your range has to flip and you have to go up, that's where we was losing it a little bit, only a little bit, but I love the changes you made. You made a couple of different changes in it from the original. I love the little flick in your head voice at the end, and with you, that little flick, that was absolutely stunning. I think it was my favorite part of the song. People got to see your falsetto today, and there was actually a note there that is originally done on a belt, and you actually did it in the top of your mixed voice, and I was looking at you thinking, wow, and that's, again, with a sore throat. So I was very impressed by that note in particular, that mixed note, and that falsetto sort of run you put in at the end, that little flick. So I think even with a sore throat and not getting to see it fully as I know it would be, I still think there was enough in that to even allow me to sit here now and say that generally on any level and any standard, you are a remarkable upcoming singer, 100%, without a doubt. Well done.
Thank you.